Are we living in a dream world? Are your eyes still green, girl? I know you're sick and tired of arguing, but you can't keep it bottled in. Jealousy, we gotta swallow it. Your heart and mind, baby, follow it. Smile, happiness, you can model it. And when you feel opposite,
I hate on making this video like this, y'all. But I know my phone getting ready to go dead, and I really had to get this off my chest. I just seen a video, and it was a celebrity, a football player, and he was talking about, you know, he was saying how one of the worst things in America is for a black man is a bitter baby mama. And I have to say this because I 100% agree with him. But my problem, and I hate putting a butt with something because it's always like, but being a black woman, black men gotta understand this. The problem with that is when y'all go fuck these women and y'all wanna have sex with these women and don't know how these women were raised and don't know the conditions of these women and y'all decide to have kids with these women, y'all can't be getting all upset and angry once you find out what kind of bitch she is. Once you find out that she got daddy issues, once you find out that she got mommy issues, that's your fault. And the reason why I'm saying that's your fault, because you don't know that shit, and you don't know the situation. So then when you have a baby by her, and she's flipped the script on your ass, and she ain't shit, and she giving you all these drugs, that's because that's your fault. How you sticking your penis in a bitch you don't even know? That makes no sense. That makes no sense at all. Now, don't get me wrong. I feel like black women can heal the black community, and I feel like we're the ones to do it. I really do. And I honestly feel like black women are definitely one of the things that are hurting black men. I can honestly say that. And what's so crazy about it, y'all, is I did the same thing. The only difference with me is I'm willing to admit what I did wrong and to my baby daddy and what I said wrong to him. And you know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, I want to be a better person for my son. You know what I'm saying? I want to be a better person for my husband. I want to be a better woman for my daughter. Like, I have people looking at me, and that's what we got to watch that shit, man. Our kids, they don't listen to what the fuck we say. They gonna do exactly what we do. So all these women that y'all going through, all these women that y'all talking about are, you know, doing all this shit, and action causes what? A reaction. And that's just her reaction because she hurt, and we don't know where to put that pain. The first motherfucking man that disappointed us was our father. So don't think for 2 minutes. We not used to black men disappointing on the most of us waiting for you niggas to do this shit. And y'all, I'm not in that particular situation because I feel like me and my husband were really strong and we really, you know what I mean? Don't get it twisted. We had to go through some shit, and it's my second marriage. But I am saying that black men, we got so much issues. We got so many issues with each other that we ain't even got time to fucking heal because nobody wants to take the blame for nothing. And I'm not saying that, oh, it's your fault, it's her fault, it's the woman's. I'm not saying that. We all need to take responsibility for what the fuck is going on in the black community, and we need to heal. That's what we have to do. All right, we fucked up. All right, baby mama's got us on child support. All right, the system fucked up. The system is not for you. We know that. I even made a mistake and accidentally put my ex-husband in the system. Not because I was bitter. Well, no, it was a lot of bitterness. I was shocked, and I was upset, and I was angry. But I didn't take in consideration what he was going through. I didn't take in consideration what he was going through at the time. But the reason being, me and him wasn't talking for those 3 years. He didn't help me at all for 3 whole years. He did not give me, he didn't even talk to my son. And that hurt me. But hurt people. So I put him on child support. That's the only way I was going to get his attention. That's the only way I was going to get him to help me. Like, that was the only thing I could do. The only thing. I literally was doing everything by myself. And as a woman, I was able to woman up and do that. But it's not fair that I had to take care of him by myself. But I hate that I had to put that man in the system, because that's not good for him. It's not good for him. If he was to lose his job today, he's going to jail. He's going to jail for not paying child support. And the man been paying his child support constantly since 2016. The system is not for us, y'all. The system is not for black men. Think about it. If I lose my job right now, the system's going to give me employment. They're going to give me housing. They're going to give me food stamps. And they're going to give me daycare to look for a job. My husband now plays child support. If my husband was to lose his job and I couldn't pay his child support, he's going to jail. Think about that shit. We don't think about that kind of stuff. The system is not for us. We need to watch who we sleep with. We need to pay attention to who we sleeping with. We need to know how they raised and who they, you know what I mean? What issues they got, what daddy issues they got, what mama issues they got. You know what I'm saying? What religious preferences they want. Do they raise the kids the same way? Do they believe in whippings? Do they cuss at their kids? Do they talk to their kids in a certain way? Like, y'all need to, we have to pay attention to that, because that is important. That shit gonna come back up in y'all relationship, how that person was raised. And the same thing with you. The same thing with you. We gotta get this shit together, because if we don't, our kids gonna go through the same shit, y'all. The exact same thing. Black love is a thing, honey. And black love is possible. And black men are, they can lead. And black women, we can be submissive. We can love our husbands and love our kids and be supportive. Like, that's who we are by nature, y'all. That's us naturally. And we don't let these motherfuckers then come and put us in this dumbass world and just fuck all that up. It makes no sense, man. It's so sick, because black men are dying emotionally and mentally. Black women are dying emotionally and mentally, spiritually. Like, we are dying inside, and we can't help each other because we so fucking mad and we so angry and we so, oh, it's his fault, it's her fault. Like, all that shit is stupid. And I'm saying this, y'all, because I became a whole different woman. My ex-husband don't even know the woman I am now. But I am going to say, yeah, he did shit in the marriage. Trust me, he did. But I did shit too. I did shit too, and I tell my son every day, me and your daddy was just young. Yeah, he did some shit and I did some shit. But I never talk bad about him to his daddy, because I don't want my son to soak that shit up in his head. I tell my son all the time, man, you just like your daddy. You do this, looks like your daddy. The good shit. Not the bad shit, because I don't want that self-esteem to fall out on my baby. And now he feel like he a bad nigga. Now he feel like he ain't shit. Now his daddy, he's none of that. That's not what I'm saying. But I'm just saying, we got to get this shit together. And we can't keep blaming just the black woman, blaming just the black man. Like, we can't keep doing that shit. We all at fault. I can tell y'all right now, 50,000 things the black woman doing wrong in the relationship with the black man, you know, co-parenting with the black man, attitude towards the black man. I can do all that. And then I can do the exact same thing for the black man, what he's doing wrong to the black woman. We got to get over that shit and start healing. We got to get over that shit. Black men, y'all need to show more fucking discipline. Y'all have discipline. Y'all don't got to walk and fuck everything that's moving. Get some discipline about yourself. Your kids are watching you. Your women, we need y'all. We already see the world for us is not going to operate when we're not together, when we're separated, when we hate each other. That's how it is. So why we keep doing the same shit, man? Our parents did this shit. Our parents' parents did this shit. Now we doing the shit? That shit is crazy. Who want to be in 10 and 9 different relationships? And you know what I'm saying? Focus on that one relationship and make that one relationship solid. Make that one relationship solid. So when mess and shit do happen, y'all can tackle that shit together. Y'all can tackle that shit like a champ. I try to explain to people all the time. I didn't leave my husband because I'm not gonna lie to y'all. That whole time my husband was cheating on me, I didn't know this shit. I didn't even know. I didn't notice anything. And I'm saying that to say, I didn't leave my husband because I was genuinely happy with my husband. I was happy. I literally made a line, y'all, and on that line I decided the good and the bad. My husband, don't get me wrong, he ain't perfect, but all his good outweighs the bad. And because I'm such a solid person, and I'm such a thoughtful and understanding person, and my husband the same way, we was able to work through that. It was not easy. By no means was it easy. Because you just took a whole bitter woman. Remember, my first husband did it. And I came into this relationship thinking different, and the same thing happened. So I'm a broken woman, and I could have did some shit, you know, as a bitter woman, but that's not what I want to be. That's not what I want my son to see. Black love is a thing. It's a fucking thing. These white families, and they ain't the only families that can be together and shit. They ain't the only families that can co-parent. We can do this shit just like they can. We taught them motherfuckers. They didn't even know how to raise their kids. We did that shit. But for some reason, we don't even want to recognize the shit, and we want to keep on blaming every motherfucking body else and blaming each other. It's over. It ain't nobody's fault. We fucked up. Now let's get it together. I say it all the time. My parents are responsible for a lot of my childhood trauma. They are, and they know they are. But it's not their fucking responsibility to heal me. I'm a grown-ass woman with kids. I have to heal myself. I have to get counseling. I gotta work through that shit. I have to do the work. That's what we gotta do together, y'all, as a whole. Don't be ashamed. Don't be embarrassed. All that shit is stupid. Fuck all that shit. We gotta get this shit together now. I just really had to get that off my chest, y'all, because I was aggravated by reading this man's comment, because everything he said, when I tell you it was right, it was true. But the black man gets shut down so much by everybody, including us. His point ain't even going. We never just want to sit and listen and be like, damn, I understand that. Now, I'm going to say this. I understand the baby mama shit because I got a brother. And my brother, he got 5 or 6 kids. 5 or 6 different baby mamas. So I'm a different kind of woman, and I understand shit because I've seen shit. You know what I mean? And then, like I said, my husband, he got a daughter. So he has a baby mama. I got a baby daddy. I'm more than sure my baby daddy hate me. I'm more than sure. But again, him hating me ain't got shit to do with nothing. I love my son more than I hate him. So whatever I need to do to make whatever I got to do work, that's what the fuck I'm going to do. And you know what I did? I said, you know what, Cherish? You going to allow your husband to handle that. Your husband, and they got a perfect relationship. Anything, something dealing with my son, anything dealing with that, they get it together. It's perfectly fine that way. This shit is possible, y'all. I'm telling you. Hurt people, man. And all we doing is we bringing that pain for our kids to have. That shit is not cool. We got to let go of some of this pain, and we have to start healing. Because if we're not going to heal, we're going to keep doing the same shit. We're going to keep talking about the same shit. The same shit. That's what's going to happen. All this bitter shit. Like, I don't want to be bitter. When I tell y'all, I was bitter for 18, well, not 18 months, because I was in counseling. But when me and my ex-husband divorced, y'all, even though I divorced him, I was so hurt. I was so mad. I was so angry. I didn't understand why he kept cheating on me. We were young as fuck, and it had nothing to do with me. But also, y'all, I also had to understand, what was it that I was doing to make him cheat? And I'm not saying that women make women, men cheat. But I am saying sometimes in relationship, men be missing shit. They try to find it somewhere else, whether it's pussy, whether it's, you know, they can't talk to you, whether it's emotionally, whether it's mentally, whatever the case it is. I know now, I want to know why. Like, what is it? Or what is it that I got going on that makes me attract niggas like that? What is it? I always get providers. I can get a nigga that's going to provide. They always match me. Every man I get, they going to always match me. And I feel like I do that because of my daddy and my brothers. My daddy's a provider. He's always showed me. If he ain't did shit, my daddy take care of his family. He take care of his kids. He take care of his wives. Like, that's what he do. But I seen that. But I've always knew that my daddy used to sleep around and used to do shit like that. You get what I'm saying? And I love my daddy. I'm a daddy's girl. And I love my brothers. I'm a brother's girl. Like, my brothers love me to death. But I seen that. So in my head, growing up, I felt like it was okay for me to cheat a little bit. I felt like that's what they were supposed to do. That was normal. But for real, y'all, what we got to figure out is why. Why are men cheating like that? What are you missing? Is it that you just need some sex? Like, we need to be able to talk to each other. I want my husband to be able to talk to me. Because I don't want to go through man after man after man after man after man after man. Man, that shit's stupid. My son about to be 14, y'all, and he ain't never seen me with no man but his daddy and my husband. Not never. Because I don't want my son to see that kind of shit. Like I said, I want my son to see me happy. Because I want my son, even though his daddy couldn't make me happy or I couldn't make his daddy happy, I want my son to see a black man make his mama happy. I want my son to see me respect and love a black man. I want my son to see a black couple, married couple, handle problems and go through problems and go through life and handle it together. That Cosby shit is real, y'all. That Cosby shit is real. I'm telling y'all. We just have to make that shit possible. We have to make that shit possible. And with us going the way we going, it ain't gonna happen. Anyway, y'all. So I have to get off of here because I'm getting heated. On top of me looking a mess. I know y'all tired of me saying I look a mess. I'm always looking a fucking mess, right? I know. I need to get myself together. But yeah, I just had to say that, y'all. And I want y'all to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell when y'all know. I mean, so y'all can know when we dropping another video. This was all just spontaneous. Me and Charles going to be on here tonight. We're going to drop a video tonight. And we're going to talk about child support and co-parenting and all that stuff. So I want y'all to tune in.